each of you here tonight. Before we get started, I introduce myself. I'm Lydia Rydell. I've seen some of you before. Ramin.
Yastampana.
And I have been playing together for almost a year. This is our third sound healing here at New Posh. And we love coming out here. It's a beautiful space. There's lots of beautiful music made in this room. So in the sound healing tonight, we kind of wanted to start off with something that's thematic and what's going on in the world today and how people are reacting to it. And putting forth some suggestions and ways that you can work to transform or transmute some of the heavier and denser emotions and reactions that you may be seeing within yourself, your family members, your friends, and just in general, all of humanity. Okay. You follow me? And I think it's timely, and this is how Ramin and I like to be of service with sound, is to really help people find ways to cope, to grow themselves, to become more whole and happy human beings. And we love to work with the sound in this way. And so tonight's theme is cultivating the garden of your soul. And those of you that you grow plants, gardens, know that the soil needs to be fertilized. So what do we put in the soil to fertilize it? All of the food, decayed food, and of all stages of that decay into the soil and turn it under so that it grows the most beautiful plants and food ever. This is a natural thing for us to do. And what I want to suggest for you tonight is that you can do this for your soul as well. You can become the gardener of your soul. And this is a little different slant on how to look at the more contracted energies of judgment, fear, anger, grief, impatience, you name it. Right? We take the opportunity to bring that in to ourselves. We just observe and watch. We become an observer of that and watch it come up as we react. Just look at that. Oh, I'm having this reaction. Anger, frustrated. It's an opportunity to take that denser, heavier emotion, and turn it under, just as if you were a gardener. So it's a very fluid way of transforming those heavier, denser emotions that we have. And in a way, transmute the poison that's coming to you. So you're turning it under and you're growing yourself, you're growing your soul for you first and then for your immediate friends and family and then of course all humanity. So the service you do to yourself for tonight with the sound, I want you to just be the witness. Should you have any judgment, if things come up, whatever, maybe there's a certain instrument that, work with that. Look at it. Pay attention to it and see it as an opportunity rather than annoying. Okay? This is what we have to do to grow ourselves. We have to really work at this. So, what we'll be doing tonight. Do you want to add anything, Ramin?
I love that, Lydia. I love the idea. I love that idea of like an emotional compost.
Oh, that's such a good word.
So good. You know, this is interesting because I've been really feeling like getting, you're prepping the garden, and you know, if I'm a little late, I know. But you know, for the winter garden, if you're growing things for the winter, this is definitely the time to do it. And I've always felt that way about gardening and getting in the soil, and that understanding when you're growing, you know, organically, you want all that stuff. You want that decomposition, right? That's good. That's good. That's good stuff.
Good stuff.
And sometimes it's funky, you know. And so I really like that. I like that understanding of, you know, that practice of working with it instead of thinking that we have to get rid of it.
Exactly.
And just to add to that, you know, because this is definitely some intense times, you know, no matter what, no matter where what you feel and the perspective, who you voted for, whatever. But I felt really kind of relieved, you know, after the election. And it felt like, as intense as these times are, it's those intense times in our lives that allow for the most growth as well. So I think this is a really good moment for us to learn, you know, to really like look at ourselves and each other and deal with these, you know, these emotions and work with them to get stronger. Individually, because we all know that if we're stronger individually, we're stronger in our communities, and our communities influence our larger communities and our world. So this is really good practice here for us all, you know, to take care of ourselves and till some of those emotions around and air them out, get them ready for some new seeds, right, to plant.
That's right. I mean, in the emotional world, there are what the Taoists like to call virtue energy, or virtue emotions, where if you are worried, that's a very dense emotion, but if you begin to trust, that's a little bit of a higher, I mean, your body can almost feel the difference when I say that.
Trust.
Yeah. Trust. Oh, you know. So these are the you know, offspring of your gardening your soul. It's a higher frequency of emotional stability that's half going to come for you from this practice. So what I thought we would do, since we're talking about being the gardener of the soul, and where does the soul reside in this vessel? This is the home of the soul and spirit. So what I'd like to do, and after y'all got all comfortable, I'm on how you stand up, because let's celebrate this vessel, and do a little work around preparation, just like you would prepare your garden, right? We're going to prepare this body, and we're going to do a little Qigong. I love Qigong.
So nice that there are 11 of us in the room here.
Oh, is there?
Uh-huh.
Oh, that's lovely. Do you want to come in to do this?
Are
you
okay? Yes. I mess up your 11.
Can you hear me?
No.
Yeah.
No.
Did you count her too? Yes.
She's the 12.
She's 12.
So it's also nice because we actually kind of like it when there are fewer people.
Yeah.
Because that gives us more of an opportunity to spend on each one of you individually.
We go around and mm-hmm. work with each of you individually, and we will help you tonight through the sound. But this will hopefully help you to prepare the body and the mind and the spirit for what's to come. So in Qigong, we have our feet flat on the floor, a little bit farther apart, hip width apart. And in the process of this, what we want to do is we want to open the body, okay, so things can come in and out. We want to clear out anything that is stuck or stagnant or, you know, just not moving. And then we want to fill ourselves. So this is kind of what we would do in a garden. You're going to till the soil, you're going to pull out the weeds, you're going to put your compost down and prepare for the planting. So this is what we're going to do tonight. It's just, so the first thing we want to do is open the body. And I love this, it's called shaking the tree. And it's very active, and you just begin to open the joints and shake. Get your breath involved in it. Making sounds if you want. You can close your eyes so you don't look at anybody. Nobody cares because you got your eyes closed. They don't care what you look like. Oh, laughing is so good too. It's another way to open the body and the lungs. To breathe down so much. You know, the joints really do get stuck with energy. How many of you have knee problems or elbows or, you know, in the shoulder? I hope Ramin is heard crack shoulder. Anyway, you know, so we just.
It was a hard hug.
Yeah, well, close enough to hear his shoulder. Right now. So we're just opening the body and you're just being that tree. Feel your roots going way down in the mother. You're really grounded here, so, you know, it's like anything can come. Self-consciousness about it. Can you do this on your own every morning when you get up? It's a wonderful way to wake up, face the east, sun coming. Stand by a tree.
Love that.
So as you're coming to a little bit of a slower pace, just kind of slow down a little bit, and then just find your way to stillness and just feel the difference in your body. Just take a moment and just feel the life force moving through this vessel. Now that we've opened everything up, we're going to use the energy of the Mother Earth to help clear things. And I'm just going to demonstrate this next one. It's going to be a little lovely. But we take our hands and we go down and we just collect the Mother's energy with our hands. And then we begin to bring it up, beaming this energy into the body, clearing, opening, clearing, opening, clearing. And when you get up here, you just release it. Oh, that feels so good. Everybody. Then the overgathering. Beautiful earth energy. We are pulling weeds. in, clearing the soil, moving the rocks, letting everything begin to flow in this body. Make the sound. Yeah! Ah. Take a couple more of those. Oh. You know, kids love this too. You can show your kids. They will just love it. They'll put you to shame because they'll embrace it. One more. We've done this, right, Joan?
I've done this before.
Yes. You've done this before, Joan.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
It is a lot of fun.
Allow you to just enjoy yourself.
Oh.
Okay.
Just take a moment. It's always good to just observe. How's the body doing? How's the mind doing? Okay. Spirit. Yeah. All right. So the last thing we want to do is good yawning. That's great. Last thing we want to do is we want to fill this beautiful body with the elixir of heaven. And this is a sweet one. We raise our arms up and over your head, imagine there's the Big Dipper right there. You grab a hold of the handle with one hand and hold the cup with the other hand and see that bowl just filling up with the beautiful essence of heaven, the sun chi, the moon chi, the earth chi, the planetary chi, the stars, the galaxy. I love to see this as purple or gold in the cup. It's just a very, very high frequency of chi coming in. And then you just open your crown, just imagine it just opens up like the iris of an eye, and you turn that bowl and you begin to pour this beautiful elixir down your crown. And you can use your hands now to help guide this down. Feel it just entering the left and right sides of the brain. The torso, the lungs, liver, gallbladder, spleen, pancreas, and stomach, heart, all being just bathed. Small intestine, large intestine. Did I leave anything out? Oh my goodness. It just feels so light and beautiful. All the way down into the legs. And just bend over. Beam it into your knees, hips, wherever you're having issues, ankles. All the way down. Down to the mother. Deep down.
Thank you. Thank you.
with this.